good morning.
Good morning.
Thank you all for coming. This is kind of a cool thing. A little bit surreal for me because my dad was a pastor, and I get to play pastor today. So this is a little different, a little bit more nervy than I thought it was going to be. But you guys will support us all through this. So a few announcements today. They gave me a list so I wouldn't mess it up. Terry made the mistake of telling me just before we started today that we are not being recorded, so I could do whatever I wanted. And, oh, I am. Oh, thanks, Jer.
Thanks, Lori.
Well, and thank you, Lori. Yeah, Lori worked real hard to make that happen this morning, and we just have a bunch of technical difficulties, and we're blaming Val because she's not here to fix it all. That's what happens when you're not here, exactly. So I'll just go through a few announcements. Church is closed tomorrow for the holiday. We do need somebody to be the liturgist and welcome announcements on the 1st, the 8th, and the 15th when Joel's on vacation. So any other volunteers want to step up and do that, that would be great. That way I don't have to do it. What else is going on? There'll be communion on the 1st of August, and Andy String will be preaching that day, and he'll be talking about the Bread of Life ministry. I'd like to thank Bobby Beck and Stephanie Zaks. They will be our new clerks of session. They're teaming up and making that happen, so thank you for your ministry there. That's good stuff. Well, it takes two, as Steph just said, it takes two to do what Jerry was doing all by himself, so and that's probably true. We're looking for somebody to take pictures at church events, so bring your cell phone, take some pictures, and I'm not too sure who you bring those or give those to, but because we all probably have cell phones now, you probably could use that and get those to whoever they go to, so that would be a big help. The praise band, the band's back together. Terry's kind of spearheading that and forcing us all to do it. But it's been a blast so far, and we're looking forward. I think our first service is the 1st of August, so tell everybody about that, and please try to attend that. That should be a lot of fun. It's at 5 o'clock. And then we also have Vacation Bible School will start on Wednesday, the 21st of July. Does anybody else have any other announcements that they'd like to let us know about? No? Okay, then we're going to have the intro. Anybody or anything specific out there that you'd like to pray for, we can add those to that. So, Lynn, what do you have?
Jean Truber's going on hospice care.
So Gene Trooper is going on hospice care, so we need to keep Gene in our prayers. Anybody else? Steph? Oh, yeah, yeah. Lynn's getting to make the long voyage over the pond, and you're leaving when?
Thursday afternoon,
wow. And you're gone for how long?
Till the 29th.
Awesome. So,
don't bring any creepy critters.
Huh? No creepy critters.
You insulted my family.
She made a bet there. Anybody else have anything that we want to pray for specifically? No? Okay. Yeah. Yeah. So can we bow our heads and pray, please? Oh, got one more.
Oh,
that was on my list as well. Okay, yeah. Next. Okay, let's bow our heads. Father God, you are ever around us. Ever holding us up. We trust that you give us peace for all the stuff that's going on. We ask for traveling mercies for the Heck family. They were all here yesterday. We put Bob in the ground yesterday next to Dottie, and that whole Heck clan was here. We ask for traveling mercies for all of them and peace for that family. Father God, you are so good to us. We ask you to be with Gene Trooper and the family. This is a rough time. Sometimes we don't understand the lies, God. But you give us strength to trust that whatever it is that your hand is on it, we don't have to know the reason all the time. We just have to trust that that's part of your plan. Father, be with us today as we worship, as we sing to you. Father, keep your hand on Linda and Jerry and the kids and the girls. Linda's having surgery on Friday, so we pray that your hand be on that. Awesome news, the tumors are going away. So we're all headed in the right direction. We all need to continue to pray for them. And Jerry and the girls, too, because they're living it as well. Be with us today as we worship and we sing. To your glory. We pray all this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Okay. I'm gonna read from the Bible. And it's Psalm 98. We left it at Psalm 98 because we didn't know how much of it I wanted to read. and thanks, Terry, for I get to do whatever I want today. Psalm 98, you've probably all heard most of it. I'm going to read the whole thing just because it's not going to take too much longer. So, sing to the Lord a new song, for he has done marvelous things. His right hand and his holy arm have worked salvation for him. The Lord has made his salvation known and revealed his righteousness to the nations. He has remembered his love. Remembered his love and his faithfulness to the house of Israel. All the ends of the earth have seen the salvation of our God. Shout for joy to the Lord, all the earth. Burst into jubilant song and music. That's licensed to do what we want to do today, so think of the hymns that you really want to do. Make music to the Lord with the harp and the sound of singing, with trumpets, thank you, Bob, and the blast of the ram's horn. Shout for joy before the Lord, the King. Let the sea resound and everything in it, the world and all who live in it. Let the rivers clap their hands. Let the mountains sing together for joy. Let them sing before the Lord, for he comes to judge the earth. He will judge the world with his righteousness and the peoples with equity. Okay, that's the end of the song. So now we get into the hymn sing part. So this is where you guys all get to participate. We're going to take selections. Mr. Blackbee, you only get one. Okay. So he was here early, and maybe I took a bribe. I did give it to the church. I did give it to the church. So what's the one you want to do? 358. And let me see, how many verses do we want to do, Al? That's four. Any particular verse you want to do? We want to do 1 and 4. Does that work for you? Do you have one that's a little more special?
Definitely one.
Definitely one? Okay. Let's do 1 and 4.
July, and what a beautiful, beautiful day we've got today. So, who wants to stump the singers?
309.
None of you, Terry, not yet. I'm a little scared. Yes, Georgie. 418.
418.
Thank you. Thanks for that.
Okay.
Big sister. Wow. Which verses?
Uh-oh.
All right, so this is the first of the month, and I always do some background on one of the hymns we sing, and I knew somebody was going to pick this hymn. There's no question. If somebody didn't do it, I was going to. So America the Beautiful. I know a lot of you know the background, some of the background to this, but there's more to the story, so I hope you'll enjoy listening. Catherine Lee Bates was head of the English department at Wellesley College in Massachusetts in the late 1800s. She was known for authoring many books and volumes of poetry. She was first inspired to write patriotic verse in recognition of the 400th anniversary of Columbus's discovery of America. The following year, she was visiting Colorado, and while viewing the countryside from the beautiful summit of Pikes Peak, she was further inspired to write a national hymn that would describe the majesty and vastness of our great land. Later that year, she visited the Columbian Exposition at the World's Fair in Chicago. On that site, magnificent buildings were erected, all masterpieces designed by Daniel Burnham. The expression Alabaster Cities was a direct result of this visit. It was her desire to compare the unusual beauties of God's nature in the country with the distinctive spectacles created by man. Miss Bates spoke often of the truth that unless we crown our good with brotherhood, of what lasting value are our spacious skies, our amber waves of grain, our mountain majesties, and our fruited plains? She would add, she often spoke of two stones, the tablets containing the Ten Commandments and the Plymouth Rock. She said, if we could only couple the daring of the pilgrims with the moral teachings of Moses, we would have something in this country that no one could ever take from us. Over many years, she revised her poem to produce the hymn we know today. At least 60 tunes have been composed and tried with that text. The one we know, Materna, was written by a New Jersey music businessman, Samuel A. Ward, years before Miss Bates wrote her poem. In 1912, permission from the composer's widow made it possible to join this tune with Miss Bates' text, Becoming America the Beautiful.
Thank you.
So what are we doing?
America the Beautiful?
Yeah, 1 and 4.
1 and 4?
1 and 4. And it's 4:18. Knows what's going on here. Terry's waving back there frantically, and we are totally ignoring. So, just wanted you in on it. Eventually, Terry, maybe.
Lynn?
Yes, we'll go with Lynn because I know she's going to try and stump us.
No, you know this one, I think. 96.
Okay, number 96.
Let's do 1 and 4. Unless there's no. Yep. Yeah. Okay. Let's do 1 and 4. Yeah. Uh oh. We might have stumped the keyboard player.
Thank you.
Okay. I'm just going to go for it. Terry, what would you like to hear?
498.
498.
Probably going to be like... Thank you. 498, I love to tell the story, and let's do 1 and 3.
Oh,
3:62. Morning, has broken. Let's do three. We don't get to do this at all.
Loose the faithful lightning of his terrible sword.
1 in 4.
1 in 4.
So one of the really neat things that's happening right now in the middle of us being up here is we're all sight reading a lot of harmony. It's kind of cool. We haven't sung for a long time.
It's real nice with the microphone.
Yeah, too.
And that's being recorded.
This might sound a little selfish, but we are.
My mom came to visit.
It's just a real, real neat time to get to sing together for us up here as well as having smiling faces now behind plexiglass way out there. So just a real blessing today. So this is awesome. So I forgot the number. Which one are we doing?
384.
384.
380. This is my father's room.
Okay, which verse? 1 and 3?
1 and 3.
Okay.
For those of us that don't know it.
Oh, you skipped elementary.
Let's say I skipped it. Okay.
Oh,
Linda?
447.
447.
Seek ye first. It's only two verses, so.
You're doing two? Because there are two?
Yeah.
Thank you.
We'll do two.
I want to hear you, Lori.
I'll try.
Be the number. How about 622? We'll keep working. We're going to get them all.
You didn't memorize that.
I didn't memorize that one.
What a friend we have in you.
What a friend.
What a friend. I want to.
Let's make it a fun game for all of us. I'm going to point at you. I want you to pick a number between 1 and 10.
Oh, boy. Uh-oh. Oh, I thought you were supposed to suggest to him. I
didn't
know you were
going to
do this.
It could be. Okay, Dwight.
My lucky number is 7.
7.
Did they go all the way up there?
Yeah. Okay. Georgie.
2.
and Terry.
Three.
723. Let's see what that is.
Oh, oh boy.
Yeah. 723. You know the story about Mexican?
We're gonna know it.
Okay, maybe
I needed this one this morning.
Alright, so let me play a little bit.
Okay.
Thank you.
Let's sing the Lord's Prayer.
626.
Six, three, two.
Different
verse. Not the one that we know.
Okay.
May the love of God be the passion in your heart. May the joy of God be your strength when times are hard. The presence of God, a peace that overflows. And the word of God, the seed that that you might sow. God bless you all. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Thank you, everyone.
Awesome.
And peace of the Lord be with you.
And also
with you.
Oh, yeah. And as you do, share greetings. I was waiting for you. And we want to thank Steph and Jeff for the catering today. So please hang around and chat. And looks like we got some good goodies going on over there. So,
consider. Yes, thank you.